गुड डे चिल्ड्रन. टू कंटिन्यू विद द सिलेबस फर्दर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद द इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. द फर्स्ट वन वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड विच हैपन्स टू बी लेसन 8 इन योर बुक. नाउ हाइड्रोजन क्लोराइड गैस इट्स सोल्यूशन वॉज इनिशियली नोन एज म्यूराटिक एसिड. इट वॉज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम NaCl and concentrated H2SO4. Because this is a marine product, so initially it was known as marine acid. It was known as marine acid, which was later on referred to as muriatic acid. And then in around 1810, its composition was studied and then it was given the name of hydrogen chloride. So that is how it came to known to man. Alright, now where does it occur in nature? It occurs in the free state, though in traces, it occurs in the free state in volcanic gases. Whenever the volcanoes erupt, a number of gases come out, so HCl gas is one of them. And then it is also found in the gastric juices. You must have done this in biology. It occurs in the gastric juices of mammals. Now, it helps in acidifying the medium of the food. Also, it helps in the process of digestion. Okay, now how is hydrogen chloride gas prepared? One method is synthesis. Synthesis means direct combination. So, that means hydrogen and chlorine can be directly combined in the presence of diffused sunlight, and it forms HCl. Now it is important that the sunlight is kept diffused. The reaction takes place best in diffused sunlight. If the sunlight will be direct, then the reaction will become explosive, and if it is dark, then the reaction is negligible. It does not take place. Moisture also helps in the process, so it acts as a catalyst. So you can say moist hydrogen combines with chlorine and HCl can be prepared. Now the reaction can also be done in the laboratory under artificial light. The reaction is continuous and it is also known as a chain reaction. The moist hydrogen will combine with chlorine and form HCl till the reaction will go on till either of the reactants is completely exhausted. So till that time the reaction will just keep going on and on. So the second method of its preparation is by the reaction of a metallic chloride, any metallic chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid. Now for example we can take say NaCl. When NaCl will combine with H2SO4, when you have to mention the concentration, you just write below it, either concentrated or dilute. So NaCl, on reacting with concentrated H2SO4, at a temperature less than 200 degrees. If the temperature is less than 200 degrees, it will form sodium bisulfate and HCl gas. The same reaction, if it is carried out at a temperature more than 200 degrees, then rather than NaHSO4, it will form Na2SO4 and HCl gas will still be evolved. Okay, the reaction could have been done with magnesium chloride or with calcium chloride or copper chloride, any of them. Okay, any of them could have reacted with concentrated H2SO4 and they would have formed the respective salt, respective sulfate, and HCl could have been given out. Out of these, this particular reaction is used for the preparation of HCl in the laboratory. Alright, so I will show you the apparatus which is required. This is the apparatus which is required. We take a round bottom flask in which we take NaCl, and with the help of a thistle funnel we pour in concentrated sulfuric acid. We have to keep in mind that the lower end of the sulfuric acid remains submerged in concentrated sulfuric acid. Otherwise, if we will not do this, then the HCl gas will evolve from here only. Alright, so to avoid that, the lower end of thistle funnel should remain submerged in concentrated sulfuric acid in the round bottom flask. Initially, we will provide some external heat from outside. The reaction will begin. Then the HCl gas which will be produced, the reaction I have already told you, it is NaCl in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 at a temperature less than 200 degrees. It will form NaHSO4 and HCl. So this is the reaction which is taking place. Now this HCl gas which is produced, it will come out from here. This is the only outlet, so it will go from here, HCl, and then we pass it into a washer bottle which contains concentrated sulfuric acid. The purpose of this concentrated sulfuric acid is to dry HCl gas. This HCl gas contains some moisture when it is produced. So when it is passed through concentrated sulfuric acid, all that moisture is absorbed by concentrated sulfuric acid, and the dry HCl, this is dry HCl. Dry HCl will pass into, this is a gas jar. We are collecting dry HCl into the jar. Because it happens to be heavier than air, so the air will be displaced in upward direction. This is known as upward displacement of air. Upward displacement of air. What does this mean? That see, whichever, even if we have a empty vessel, it is always filled with air. So similarly, this will be filled with air. When HCl will begin to come, because it is heavier than air, so it will keep on depositing air, and whatever air was here will be displaced in the upward direction. So this is known as upward displacement of air. You can be asked, how is HCl gas collected? So you will say it is collected by upward displacement of air. What property of HCl is indicated by its method of collection? So you will say, because it is denser than air, it is heavier than air, so it is collected by upward displacement of air, or this property of HCl is depicted by its method of collection. Alright, now when this is to be prepared, so we take, I have already told you, NaCl is reacted with concentrated H2SO4. Initially the temperature is controlled all through the reaction. It is controlled, it is kept below 200 degrees, and NaHSO4 which will remain here only, and HCl will give out. Now related to this, we have certain reasoning questions. You can keep the diagram in mind and answer these questions one by one. So the first one is, why is sodium chloride preferred over other chlorides? I told you initially that we could have taken either magnesium chloride or calcium chloride or copper chloride. Out of all of them, why is it that we prefer this sodium chloride? So sodium chloride is preferred because it is not very expensive and it is very easily available. It is easily available. Alright, so it is not that it will be found only at certain places. It is found in every city, everywhere. So that is one reason. Then why is concentrated sulfuric acid used? This you have already done it a number of times. Because it is non-volatile. It boils at a very high temperature. So it is not that along with HCl, H2SO4 will also be evaporated. Because it is non-volatile, it has a high, you can write that, high boiling point. That is why it is preferred over any other acid. Why concentrated nitric acid cannot be used? Because this is volatile. When suppose in this preparation, instead of concentrated sulfuric acid, suppose we are taking HNO3, then when HCl gas will begin to come out, concentrated nitric acid will also come out with it. Now if one of the reactant is gone, naturally the reaction will come to a stop and we will not be able to prepare HCl. So that is why we avoid taking HNO3. Alright, so it is volatile and it may volatize along with HCl. This is the reason for it. HCl gas. Okay, why should the temperature controlled, why should it be maintained less than or around 200 degrees? This is a very, very important question. Now, it is to be kept because at a lower temperature, besides HCl, it results in the formation of NaHSO4. You have already written the reaction. NaCl on reacting with H2SO4 at a temperature less than 200 degrees, it will form NaHSO4 and HCl. So we would prefer NaHSO4 to be formed rather than Na2SO4. At a higher temperature, the same reactants will give you 200 degrees. It will give you Na2SO4 and HCl. Now the problem is that when Na2SO4 is formed, this Na2SO4 sticks to the bottom of the round bottom flask. It sticks over here. Okay. When it sticks, so let it be. If it is sticking, what is the problem? The problem is that this is a non-conducting layer. Later on, if you will use the same apparatus and you will provide heat from outside, this layer will not let this heat go inside to the contents of the round bottom flask. So that means either after every use you discard the round bottom flask or let the temperature be lower than 200 degrees. Okay. And besides, another thing is very relevant common sense thing is, if you can provide the required product at a lower temperature, why should you increase the temperature? Because if you are increasing the temperature, you are only wasting the fuel. The fuel is being wasted. Alright. So this is one thing, though less important. And second thing is, the glass apparatus, the entire procedure is carried out in glass apparatus. This glass apparatus may break, or you can say crack at a higher temperature. So why should you increase the temperature when you can obtain the product at a lower temperature? Then after that, another thing is that the sodium sulfate which is formed, it will stick to the glass and it is very difficult to remove it. It actually fuses with the glass. Okay, so you can't scratch it. You can't scratch it physically. You can't dissolve it in an acid. It forms a very hard crust. Okay, and it is very difficult to remove it. So these are the main reasons why we avoid increasing the temperature beyond 200 degrees. Okay, now the next step is that after HCl is prepared, we use H2SO4 to dry it. Why, there are other drying agents also. Why do we use concentrated sulfuric acid to dry? Okay. So, the purpose is that concentrated sulfuric acid can absorb moisture very well. So, it can remove the moisture. It can absorb the moisture and dry the gas. The other agents are not used. For example, calcium oxide is a good drying agent, but we avoid using calcium oxide because HCl, you all know, is acidic in nature and calcium oxide is basic. Now when an acid and a base will come in contact with each other, they are likely to react. So calcium oxide will react with HCl and it will form calcium chloride and water. So don't you think if we allow this to use, some amount of HCl will be used up in reacting with calcium oxide, so the yield of HCl will fall down. Yes, will become less. Okay, so that is why we avoid it. Similarly, with P2O5 also, HCl can react and it will form phosphorus oxychloride, POCl3, phosphorus oxychloride, and it also forms metaphosphoric acid. And this is known as phosphorus oxychloride. Anyway, whatever the products are formed, but HCl is reacting with P2O5 and with the result, the yield of HCl is becoming less. So that is why we avoid using these two. Now this is also another important question. Why can't we use calcium oxide or P2O5 for drying HCl gas? So you will say because they react with HCl and reduce the yield of HCl. Now, why is HCl collected by the upward displacement of air? Why? You already know this. This is because it is denser than air. It is about 1.28 times heavier than air. Alright. Now, why is it not collected over water? Because it is very soluble in water. Very highly soluble in water. Okay, like one volume of water will dissolve 452 volumes of HCl. All right, so it is that at normal temperature, ordinary at room temperature. Okay, so so much of it can be dissolved in water. So that is why we avoid using water for its drying. Rest of the things we will do in the next video, children. This was regarding the preparation of HCl. Okay, have a nice day, children.